Kamala Harris. Who on that list is Kamala Harris going to defeat? You have Donald Trump. She's not going to defeat him. Ron DeSantis and Mike Pence and Ted Cruz. I would assume those are the biggest ones. Who's Kamala Harris going to defeat? And I'm assuming Joe Biden's not going to be there anymore. Am I missing something? This woman is a terrible politician. The Democrat primary voters flatly rejected her. The Democrats are in trouble in 2024, right?
Yeah, I think they're definitely in trouble, but I think that Republicans should also be cognizant of where the country is and where we're moving. Personally, I do not actually believe that Donald Trump can beat Kamala Harris. The reason that I don't believe that Donald Trump can beat Kamala Harris is that the history of the first woman president versus essentially going back to where we would have been 4 years ago, I don't think that the country will be moving with Donald Trump at that point. Keep in mind, yes, Donald Trump had 74 million votes, but those 74 million are not guaranteed 74 million who will be voting for him. Again, what I think that Donald Trump should do is focus on his America First priorities, getting those candidates that support those policies. I think that would be a benefit. Just from a strategic point of view, what I think that the Republican Party needs to do is to have something to match up with Kamala Harris. Unfortunately, having another white man run against Kamala Harris, that's not gonna win it. I do not believe that any white male will be able to beat Kamala Harris. In comes Kristi Noem, even Tim Scott and Nikki Haley. I think that the Republican Party will make a mistake if they are continuing over the next 4 years pushing the notion that Donald Trump is the person to beat in 2024. I do not believe it, and I actually don't think that Donald Trump is going to run. I think he's enjoying being the kingmaker, because be rest assured, whoever is that candidate in 2024, they will have to have Donald Trump's blessing. Whoever.
Malik, I'm glad you brought up Tim Scott, because here's my issue. A friend of mine told me, and I thought he put it a really great way, that Tim Scott is a decent man in an indecent time. And what he meant by that was, I mean, he does come across as a statesman. I mean, the kind of guy you look at, you think, yeah, I can see that dude leading things. But we are in a time of vicious brawling now, and the left has gotten more bold and more nasty and more aggressive. And I disagree with you on this. I do not think the Republican base is ready for any kind of statesman. I think they're going to want some kind of bare-knuckle boxer.
No, I actually agree with you on that. But there's the 74 million that voted for Donald Trump, they don't represent the Republican base. And that is where the rub. That's where the rub is. I think that Tim Scott represents what the Republican Party is in many ways where we're going. I don't think that, you know, if Republicans convince themselves that we need to have another base election, we're going to lose, because the base did not elect Donald Trump. Yes, we can get into the theories about the election being stolen here and there, but the fact is that base that we're talking about, that base that went around saying that it was going to be a landslide for Donald Trump, that base wasn't enough to reelect him in office. And you pair that with Donald Trump's personality, that even though I supported him twice in 2016 and 2020, what I was hearing around the country is that people were exhausted about his personality. If the Republicans move forward saying, well, Donald Trump's personality really doesn't matter, then we're going to lose in 2024, because you have to at least like the person that you're voting for. That's how Joe Biden ran. Not because he's some great, you know, politician. People liked him more. That's what it's all. People are less likely to vote for someone that they don't like. They liked Joe Biden, not because he was a great guy. They just liked him better. And I think that that's what's going to be the factor in 2024.